Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So, we are going to present about Alliance Islamic Bank Berhad as our case study for risk management in Islamic finance. This is our table of contents on this presentation, 1.0 Introduction, 2.0 Risk in Islamic Finance, 3.0 Alliance Islamic Bank Berhad, 4.0 Risk Management in Alliance Islamic Bank Berhad, 5.0 Conclusion. Hi and assalamualaikum to everyone. My name is Nur Fariza binti Yaakob. I am from IC1105 Introduction. Financial risk is the uncertainty arising from possible losses in financial markets due to the movements of financial variables, which can influence the achievements set by the financial institution. The risks arise from the products and services offered by them and the business activities engaged in it to magnitude of risk. So generally, we know that each financial institution will face the financial risk. So we would like to study on how Alliance Islamic Bank Berhad able to manage the risk. Next, we move to 2.0, which is risk in Islamic finance. Types of risk face. There are two types of risk face, which are financial risk and non-financial risk. Market risk, credit risk, and liquidity risk classify as financial risk, while operational risk, Sharia compliance risk, and reputation risk classify as non-financial risk. Market risk generally affected the changes of price markets. Credit risk appears due to the risk of counterparty failing to recognize its obligation on time. And liquidity risk is related to institutions' cash flow. Next, operational risk is the risk may happen because of the mankind and technical errors or accident happening directly or indirectly. Sharia compliance risk is to ensure the consistency of Sharia in order to prevent elements of non-compliance with Sharia principles. And lastly, reputation risk is increase the risk of funds withdrawals and equity withdrawals from depositor and investor.
So for the first risk management process is identify the risk, which is analyzing the risk involved in terms of various risks inherent to each product activity. Such as the risk might happen is liquidity risk, credit risk, operational risk, and so on. The second process of risk management process is assess the risk, which is adopt quantitative and qualitative approach to measure and assess the risk in terms of quantum, severity of impact, and likelihood of occurrence. Okay. The third process of risk management process is mitigation and control, which is examine various measures to mitigate and monitor the risk. Fourth is monitoring, which is monitor the risk and control indicators. In this case, the bank will monitor the significant risk happen and watch the adverse trend of the risk. Later, the bank will take a corrective measure to have the improvement by review the strategy and the risk management process. And the last but not least is reporting escalating disclosure, which is furnish periodic risk report to senior management and the board and provide disclosure to investor and regulators via statutory and regulating reporting.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Wan Nur Amni binti Wan Muhammad Ismail. So I will continue our discussion with 4.0, which is risk in Alliance Islamic Bank Berhad. So there are six types of risk that will be managed by this bank, such as credit risk, market risk, liquidity risk, operational risk, reputational risk, and Sharia compliant risk. We move to the first type of risk, which is credit risk. Fariza had explained before this the meaning of credit risk. There are many challenges and solutions that faced by Alliance Islamic Bank Berhad while managing the credit risk. One of the challenges is the bank has inefficient data management among employees that can cause into the difficulty to obtain the right customer's data. For example, one bank do not have correct information about their customers' exit value and entry value because it is not being recorded properly before this. The next challenge is bank always reworks against things such as the policy models and working standards that can lead to an overlap of information that would have an adverse impact on bank's efficiency ratio. This situation will not bring justice to all of their customers. The third challenge is the bank has insufficient risk of tools. This can cause banks to be unable to identify customers' portfolios when it comes to managing this risk. So, how does Alliance Islamic Bank manage this risk and this challenge? So, one of the solutions is they establish a regular guide. It is to facilitate the management of credit risk within the organization. The guide, namely Credit Risk Management Framework. So, the next solution is the bank do the improvement of their quality of customer portfolios by Portfolio Review Committee. This will, the bank will manage their customers' portfolio according to two different forms of financing, such as retail financing and corporate financing. The third solution is they will do the early warning framework to resolve the problem arising from revised portfolio. The early warning framework actually is a systematic process for the bank to evaluate and measuring risk in early stage to avoid all of the risks that will occur later. Next, 4.2 is market risk. There are three ways used by Alliance Islamic Bank Berhad in managing the market risk. One of them is Group Risk Management Committee do the review and approve all of the risk management policies. Actually, the policies are recommended and designed by Group Assets and Liabilities Management Committee to ensure that the risk market achieve the appropriate levels and parameters so they can apply all of the policies in their business strategy and planning. Next, they use the three lines of defense concept. Three line of defense actually is a step that require the involvement of three different parties to launch the market risk management. Let's see, the first line is actually represented by the group financial market. So they have to manage risk or take action against threats at an early stage. This step will help them to avoid the risk from the start of the activity or the business. Next, the second line. Second line of defense is group risk management or standard setters for each organization. They have to take the risk accountability process. So they have to create a policy and process of risk management, provide guidance to all constituencies, identify market trends and opportunities that can be taken in a business. Lastly, the third line. The third line is the actually represented by group internal audit. So, they have to do all the monitoring activities such as providing practical risk management content. They have to check all the governance report and ensuring that the risk management process carried out are valid and appropriate to use. The last way that used by them is they have to identify the market risk that will exist in the journey of a new product and changes in risk profile based on exposure to previous risk. This means that if they identify the risk in their production of new products, they are well prepared with the risk, with the incoming risk in the future, so they do not have to repeat the same risk that they had faced before this in the other products. The third type of risk is liquidity risk. There are four ways used to overcome this risk. First of all is liquidity gap analysis. It is descent in supply or demand for a security or the maturity dates of securities. When there is the difference between supply and demand, it will lead to liquidity gap itself, which means the bank might experience a shortage of cash. Next is stress testing. It is a test to show the ability of banks to meet near-term payment obligation under funding loss and other counterparty cash drains. So there are many approach used to perform this testing, such as bank internal liquidity risk models, balance sheet liquidity measures, and scenario tests such as the Basel liquidity coverage ratio. Last but not least, The way is diversification of funding sources. There are many ways to diverse the fundraising, such as incorporate peer-to-peer fundraising, create a virtual component to the event, develop a monthly giving program, and form strategic partnerships. So that's all from me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum and hi, my name is Ainul Dini. I'm from IC105BB. For my part, I will continue with three other risks, which are operational risk, syariah compliance risk, and reputational risk. In general, Alliance Islamic Bank manage this risk by combining three key features, which are first, develop risk framework, second, use methodologies and tools, and lastly, apply active risk communication. Okay, let's start with operational risk. So how does this bank manage its operating risk? First, the bank developed operational risk management framework, which is a strategic plan to manage risk before implement it. As ISO 31000 states that the successful of risk management will depend on the effectiveness of the framework, as the planning is very important before implement it. So that's why having a framework is very important. Second, the methodologies and tools used by bank to develop framework earlier are using these four things. Okay, let me explain one by one. First, RCSA is for identifying, assessing and controlling operational risk, while to manage the effectiveness of RCSA is using CSA. Okay, next, KRI is to manage risk that can be exposed over time, while LED is to collect and report loss as incidents involving near losses or actual losses. Third, active risk communication is applied by organizing operational risk awareness training program periodically among staff to reinforce risk awareness message. As a result, the staff will be more careful and concerned about this risk. And under this box is the three bodies that are responsible to manage operating risk in this bank. Let's go to syariah compliant risk. Just same like operational risk before, first, the bank has established syariah governance framework. Second, to ensure the syariah compliance in the activity of the bank, it must have a review, monitor and report, and this role will be done by the three bodies at the bottom of the box, as all of you can see. And third, bank also have syariah non-compliance risk awareness program periodically amongst staff. Okay, lastly, reputational risk. First, bank has established reputational risk management framework. Second, bank use analysis, rating and benchmark, as these tools and methodologies can show the level of reputation in this bank. And third, the staff are also guided by bank vision, mission and core values. Therefore, this is the result of our study on how Alliance Islamic Bank Berhad manage their risk well to this day.
In conclusion, risk management practice is really important element that should be monitored efficiently in order to reduce the impact and likelihood so that the residual risk can be brought within the tolerable loss range. Finally, it is hoped that Alliance Islamic Bank Berhad will continue to thrive and succeed in the future, not only in Malaysia but internationally as well. That's all from us. Thank you.